So in the lecture of this module, we try to understand how we can work with remote sensing data to understand land ownership and management, or we call it also land tenure and management. The learning goals are therefore to grasp the importance of land tenure to achieve the sustainable development goals, and at the same time to have a look at the various aspects and different spatial scales at which we can apply remote sensing methods and use remote sensing data to monitor the access to land and resources, and also to contribute to or ensure the access to land and land management. So why is land tenure actually so important? It's one of the global pressing issues of our time. And as we speak of now, only 30% of the world's population has officially registered access to land. And this can be either in urban context or urban environments, as we can see in the picture which I brought you, but it can also be in rural areas, or is especially a problem in rural areas. So it's a global problem with manifold local consequences. And it also has been recognized by the World Bank, who has published a series on reports and also blog posts, which you might want to read, where they recognize that the insecure access to land is one of the big hindering problems in terms of economic development and social security. Being such a cross-cutting issue, aspects of land tenure or land tenure per se is key to achieve a number of different sustainable development goals. There are five. And if you want to have a deeper look into the role of land and SDGs, I recommend you to have a look at the land portal. I got this picture or summary also from that webpage. It's an NGO which works explicitly on this topic. So we have the goal, no poverty, zero hunger, gender equality, sustainable cities and communities, and life on land. And in fact, land tenure or the access to land and resources are explicitly mentioned in the number of targets and indicators. I've brought you two because there are so many. And example would be target 5A, where reforms should be undertaken to give women equal access to economic resources, among them land, or indicator 142, which is the measure or the proportion of total adult population with secure tenure rights to land. Before we move into the more practical aspects of all this, I would like us to have a common understanding of land tenure or what land tenure means. So it's commonly referred to as a set of rules regarding management and ownership of land and also of resources. And this set of rules, these different agreements between people, they can be either recognized formally by a governmental institution or governing body, or it can be formulated among people or groups without necessarily being recognized from outside of this group. So we differentiate here between formal tenure and customary tenure. And as I've said before, like this formal tenure, the officially recognized access to land or land parcels only applies to roughly a third of the population of this globe. So you might imagine that we have a number of different rules, a number of different regulations, which all form this land tenure. And commonly these aspects are referred to as sticks in a bundle, or the whole thing as a bundle of rights. And to understand that a bit further, I've brought you this very popular graph or drawing, which shows the five different, let me say, bigger groups of rights, and they are either linked to access or taking something, so access to resources or withdrawal from resources, or they talk really about management and access to land. We then talk about the management of land, so if someone wants to plant something, the exclusion, you can also exclude someone from entering your property, which is a certain right, or the alienation, which is one of the most powerful rights, so that you can alienate a plot of land to your heirs. And you might think, like, why are we talking about this when we actually want to talk about remote sensing of land management? I want you to understand, or I think it became now obvious, that it's hard to tangle these issues with remote sensing data, or actually impossible. So I would like to conclude about this introduction, or this section, which is more about definition and wording, that property rights and tenure cannot be detected by satellite imagery, and management schemes cannot be classified by algorithms. The level of security of tenure can simply not be evaluated from space. And also, if these tenureship and agreements change, it cannot be really monitored, like with time series or other remote sensing methods. But, and that's key, we can use remote sensing methods to monitor the effects of different land tenure and land tenure regimes, and we can use satellite imagery to also contribute to better tenure and secure tenure. So as remote sensing expert, we can, in the overall, contribute to an optimization of land management and tenure management. A while ago, I've published a paper on the assessment of land reforms based on remote sensing, which are part of land tenure or change of land tenure. And I came up with 7 broad categories. They can be more, they can be less, but I try to summarize it in these. And these categories apply on different aspects of land tenure agreements. So we have aspects on legality or assessment criteria on legality. One example would be how high is the level of tenure security. We would have aspects of efficiency. One example would be how much crops are produced per hectare. We have issues or assessment criteria of effectiveness to have a look how much area in total, or how big is the area in total which is under production under certain tenures. We have the aspect of equity. Is it actually fairly distributed, the land and the resources? We have aspects of economic viability, governmental aspects, and also environmental aspects, where I brought one example here, which is the sustainability of land use, or maybe also the conservation of certain resources. So we cannot really map land tenure and land management and access to resources, but we can measure the effects or certain assessment criteria. So we can have a look at how efficient certain tenure systems are by having a look at how crop production is going. We can have a look at the environmental sustainability of land tenure system or different land holding concepts by evaluating how sustainable these land uses are. And I've brought you some showcases where I think it becomes a bit more obvious how tenure shapes the land cover, which we can monitor with remote sensing. And then later on in practical session, we will try to understand these examples which I brought you in more detail.